maneuvers while we scan your ship.
Thank you.
Hey, Cap. Neutralize suspect. Anything you need?
Hey, what can I do for you? Okay, no problem.
Thank you.
speed and heading while we scan you for contraband.
Okay. watch it. Ships coming and going all the time.
Do you have business with the Trade Authority?
You should inspect your ship for heat leeches.
Anything I can help you with? Okay, no problem.
Thank you. Captain, hello. I am satisfied to see that you survived your most recent sleep cycle.
Are you looking to start something?
Drag us off and scrap us for organs.
Mr. Halftown, our security officer has been put into the infirmary trying to find your worker. We're doing everything we can. All I ask is that you and your crew be patient. You have nothing to fear from us convicts. We are handling it.
Then get it done. Or else we are going to have problems.
You have my word. I'm sorry, love, but the Elios retreat isn't taking new residents right now. We've had some issues. A missing person chief among them. But you're welcome to rest up and refuel here as long as you'd like. So long as there's no bounty hunter after you that's going to kick my brand new door off its hinges. Not yet, but it's certainly a risk, given the retreat's intended line of business. But I'm not about to send anyone packing who might just need a place to collect themselves. Well, at the moment, it's primarily a collection of shipping containers and unused construction materials. But the plan is to make this place into a growth and education residence for the galaxy's incarcerated. We'll offer job training and a support network for folks that otherwise just while away their days in prison just because they didn't have the credits to pay their own bounties. Get them all the tools they need to set up regular, boring lives like the rest of us. Well, thank you. Always striving to make my presence in the universe a net positive. But still got a lot of ground to cover. But I'm sure you didn't come all this way just to listen to me blabber. You're probably exhausted. Monica should have any supplies you might need. She's just out front of the main building. And our ship services tech is out near the landing pad if your vessel needs some tending to. And if you need anything else, or just want to talk, you come find me. But once we officially open our doors, the retreat's going to have to be a lot of things to the formerly incarcerated folks we plan to bring here. Residence, school, a place for reflection. Nevin, he handles everything infrastructure related, while I take care of everything our residents might need to get them moving along healthier paths. I make sure we've got the facilities to support everyone. I arrange all our occupational training. Even got my counseling certification a few years back so I can serve as a compassionate ear when people need it. That the truth? Because I can't say it's going to be easy work. But if you found the construction crew's missing man, we'd all owe you. Well, he was last seen a few days ago, so we don't think he could have gotten far. We sent our lone security officer to find him. But things didn't go according to plan out there, and now he's taken up residence in our infirmary. So if you're offering, we'll absolutely take the help. This planet is not the most accommodating to human life. It's wild, empty, and the local fauna, well, they're not big fans of humans. So while I will absolutely take your help if you're offering it, I just want you to be aware, I don't expect it's going to be a walk in the park. You don't know how happy I am to hear it. First things first, you want to speak to Greg D'Angelo, our security officer. He was wounded searching for our worker, Mr. Kilman's trail. He should be able to get you pointed toward Kilman's last known location.
are you? Can't a guy heal in peace? Sloan found someone else, huh? Well, hopefully, you'll have better luck than I did. I managed to turn up some tracks outside the facility. Bit of a hike, though. Not sure if they were Killmans, but Ixil's not exactly a bustling metropolis. There was a cave system. I scanned nearby, but I got attacked before I could look any further. Next place I was planning to visit once I was on my feet again. I'd start there.
Thank you. not going back. Stay away. Oh God, please, please don't put me back in the bag. I'll do whatever you say. Just please, not the bag. What happened? You're not here to... I was kidnapped. He caught me off guard after hours, threw a bag over my head and marched me off. But I escaped. But then these creatures started hunting me. So I ran in here. And I've got no food and I'm so hungry and... Please, take me back. I just want to go home. No. No, he kept the bag over me the whole time. I heard his voice, but he honestly didn't say much when I was around. I need this to be over. Please. Please, can we go? Please? The retreat? Back with those... Fine. Anywhere is better than here. You do know the way back, right?
Mother of God, kid. What happened?
I was walking out, and someone threw a bag over my head. They took me... I don't know. It smelled like the inside of the first aid kit. I had to sleep on a steel floor and...
Which one of you crooks bagged him, huh?
Us? Why the hell would we do that? Waste of a perfectly good bag.
You're rambling, kid. Come on. Let's get you cleaned up. You smell like used welder's gear.
Mr. Halftown, I have some medical training. I'd be happy to.
You stay away from me. I want whoever kidnapped my man found and dealt with, understand? I don't care if it's one of your people or mine or a fucking ghost. Find them.
Of course. We'll do what we can. But...
I'm not interested in excuses. I need to know who did this. Just find my man's kidnapper now.
Kill him. He's alive. Amazing.
I guess it might have been a bit naive for me to hope for a happy reconciliation, but you brought him back safe. That's what's important. Here, you have my sincerest thanks. But now, we've got a whole new thread to pull on. What are the chances I'd be able to convince you to help us find our kidnapper? Thank the heavens. So, we just need to figure out where we're sending you. Now, Mr. Kilman didn't seem to have a lot of information, but I caught at least one or two bits I think could help us find our kidnapper. He did, didn't he? Industrial antiseptic would be my guess. I know that smell. There was a building we were evaluating as a possible site for the retreat not far from here. An old research outpost. Seems like a decent match for the description of our kidnapper's hideaway. Here, the facility's coordinates. Head out there and see what you can find.
this area. You seem to have weathered that trek well enough. Were you able to find anything at the facility?
Not a lot to go on.
Monica, anything you can do with this?
I can take a look. Oh, it's encoded. Made to look scrambled. And done badly. Looks like... there. Seems there were two of them. Oh my god, it's all here. The accidents, the kidnapping, Greg's attack. These two, they did it all.
Any mention of who they are? They're not with the construction crew, are they?
No names, but there are a pair of ID numbers. They're with the Trackers Alliance.
The Alliance sent two bounty hunters? Here? But our bounties are all paid.
I'm not seeing an Alliance contract or documentation. I think this is off the books.
So, a couple of Trackers have decided to haunt us on their own free time. Why?
Doesn't say. It's really not that impressive. Used to sell these on the semi-regular in my old life. A cheating spouse wants to document all their flings without fear of their partner finding out? Just use one of these bad boys. It's computer hacker 101 stuff. And it sure doesn't explain why they've decided to harass us.
That certainly seems in the realm of possibility.
So then this is an easy fix. They're bounty hunters. We pay them to leave us alone.
And make ourselves a target for every other hunter in the universe. We need to take a stand.
Says the one guy physically incapable of taking one.
We're not doing anything until we actually find them. Any mention in there of where our trackers might be now?
Sounds like they're on a supply run, outside the system.
Then we got a little time. Given their background, and ours, I expect you're the only person here they might actually listen to. Would you be willing to act as an emissary on our behalf?
Slate's not big on details. There's two of them, they're clearly armed, but that's about all we've got to go on.
But trackers aren't usually the type to take prisoners when it's not required. So the fact that they've thus far remained largely non-violent, well, it means they might be willing to negotiate. With the right person, of course, which I think in this case is you. I'm sure we can find a way to solve this issue, which won't require bloodshed.
Let's just pay them and be done with it. I mean, we clearly need more manpower anyway. I'll hire them on as contractors.
To hell with that. We know where they live. Let's have our friend here get the drop on them and send them to the great beyond.
The last thing we need is the galaxy thinking that's how we solve our problems around here, Mr. D'Angelo. I would request you try to avoid any violence. But if you're looking for suggestions on how to proceed, well, it seems we've got opinions to spare.
I think there's a clear way to solve this problem. But the ultimate way forward, I suppose, falls to you. I'm the facility's chief administrator, co-head of the whole retreat with Sloane. She handles most of the resident side of things. Making sure we've got the right people for the program and those people have the right tools to succeed in their own development. I keep the lights on and make sure things hum along smoothly. Currently, very little. But once we're open, should that day ever come, we hope to have all manner of training and personal development courses available for our residents. Most of our staff are formerly incarcerated themselves, so we hope to be able to provide a level of service unlike any other in the galaxy. Ah, I am the sole exception. I was a neighborhood administrator for years in New Atlantis. Was tasked with maintaining the wells section of the city. Home to many of the UC's most underprivileged citizens. I saw firsthand what havoc the bounty system could cause in a neighborhood. Parents in prison, money funneled away from basic needs. It can become a cycle. Here, we hope to give people the tools to escape it. I think you should offer them money, and I'm willing to help. Here, all I have liquid at the moment. Hopefully it'll be enough. Take care, please.
Did I mention thanks for taking these two on? Most of the staff here are. Got me for digital intrusion and grand larceny. Was in a bad place. Needed a lot of funds. Fast. So I hacked a couple Galbank servers. Had maybe 6 years left on my sentence in Aquila when Sloane and Nevin swooped in. They said they'd pay off my whole bounty if I ran through their pilot program. I didn't have much else going on, so I said sure. It was hard work. But Sloane, the woman is compassion in human form. She stuck with me. And now I'm here, running the retreat shop and maybe someday one of my own. Sure did. Anyone who commits to joining the program gets their bounty paid off by the retreat. Not sure who's footing the bill, though. I presume it's coming from outside donations, because Sloane and Nevin aren't exactly rolling in cred sticks. Had to deal with my fair share of their kind over the years. You don't get into that job to make it rich. You get into it to be your own boss and prove how tough you are. So, my advice? Let them know that pushing around a bunch of counselors just makes them look like bullies, not tough. Hand-selected by yours truly. Be careful with those goons.
I would hate for anyone else to get hurt in all this, so please try to solve things peacefully.
If you can believe it, I was Crimson Fleet. Scouring the skies for loot and glory. Ended up finding a hefty prison sentence instead, which, honestly, was probably the best for me and the galaxy at large. I'm not gonna tell you there weren't things I enjoyed, but you've gotta understand, that sort of life is a short fuse. I hope for your own sake, you'll look for other paths, love. But I'm sure you didn't come here for an ancient history lesson. Was there something else you wanted to discuss? Well, like I mentioned, the retreats are a modest attempt to change how the galaxy deals with those who find themselves on the wrong side of the law. Once we're open, the goal is to take in people whiling away in prison because they couldn't pay their bounties. We'll get them job training and a support network. All the tools they need to set up regular, boring old lives just like the rest of us. We're trying to do what we can to help those who need it. Love, I can only guess at what these two might be after. But it's clear they perceive something about us as a threat. They're afraid. And all you can do with fear is try and understand it. So, just listen to them, okay? Hear what they have to say. And see if you can make whatever it is they're worried about a little less scary. Good luck out there.
You looking for my suggestion? I don't think they're gonna respect anything other than force. But I think Sloane's not gonna be happy if you handle it that way.
who's that?
No clue. You! Who are you and what the hell are you doing here? And just who the holy hell are you?
See? I told you Kilman was gonna lead them to us. Should have slit his throat when we had the chance.
Quiet. Listen, unless you're here to tell us those convicts had decided to close up shop, then we've got nothing to discuss. I couldn't care less about the cons. They can huff fish innards until they rot for all we care. But this retreat, if they actually succeed, keep criminals out of the bounty system, well, the galaxy probably doesn't need so many trackers at that point, does it? And then maybe the big boys like the UC and the Collective set up programs of their own, just like Elios. Put us all out of a job. Now, better to nip it in the bud now before it becomes a threat. Which is why I'm not interested in discussing anything except the date and time they're shutting their doors. More than you can offer. Only way this stops is if that place closes up for good. That's so. I guess that's a good point. I don't know what you're talking about. Fine. We'll leave the retreat alone. Can't make any promises about us being the last, though. Just get out, all right?
The retreat's safe. From us, at least.
There you are. You were gone for quite a while, love. Are you all right? Were you able to find our trackers? It's done? Well, I guess I better get started. You are one of the most reliable souls I've come across in a long time. This place, all of us, we are in your debt. There is just one last piece of business, though. Nevin asked to speak to you, in private. He's waiting for you up in the office.
Ah, there you are. So, first things first, I need to say, well, thank you. And we are exceedingly grateful for it. It's just the situation you set right with the trackers. It's one we don't want to find ourselves in again. Luckily, we have someone, our founding donor, in fact, who has offered to reach out to the Alliance, ensure their good behavior going forward. Before she does, however, she's asked for the details of what exactly occurred. I've already shared my own insights, but, well, she wants to talk to you, too. Is that something you might be amenable to? Our benefactor has said she'd prefer to do the introductions herself. But you can rest assured she wants only to thank you in person. Hear your side of the story. Nothing more sinister than that. Ah, she'll be pleased to hear it. Head to Aquilas City in the Cheyenne system. Check in with Justin Sneed, her security chief. And I would ask you to try and be polite. She's the only reason we're here.
Hey, look who's alive. Guessing things went well with the trackers, then. Can I get you something?
Captain. Always listen to Delgado. Unless you want to get killed.
Well, now that you're...
Now you buy from me.
Let's get you set up. See ya.
Kinetics, electromagnetics.
If it isn't the pirate who's
not,
take your pick.
For blast to the face.
All right. See you around.
universals out in the stars. To get closer to God and to appreciate the galaxy and all its majesty. Of course. Stay safe.
Thank you.
have the firepower to blow you apart. Let's do this.
Thank you. Virginia says you've been tearing
well,
up the
it
mission
isn't
board.
Isn't the pirate who saved
gonna
the
take
fleet.
A lot to beat your high score.
It's good business having you here. If your credits are good, I'm open.
Done here? Fine by me.
Need something?
The legacy, managing finances on this scale won't be easy. But make no mistake, I'm well equipped. Until next time.
Sure, sure. Let me punch that up, and we can have at it.
Thank you.
A slow ship will get you caught. Talk to Jazz if you need upgrades.
I like my weapons like I like my coffee. Scalding.
Thank you. tower's closed. Come back some other time. You're them, huh? I've got two rules for this little meeting. Rule number one, you're not to share anything you discuss up there. This is a private matter, and we're going to keep it that way. Rule two, you decide to get playful with that weapon, we're going to have serious problems. Think you can abide by those? Good. Miss Lance is waiting upstairs. You can go on up.
And that must make you our guest. Please, take a seat. You don't have anything to fear from me. Now, you may already know who I am. Raisha Lance, CEO Laredo Firearms. And you, I know all about. I can't thank you enough for everything you've done for the retreat. Truly, it's a project that's near and dear to my heart. I'm not the sole donor, but yes, the retreat is a project I've been trying to foster for some time now. My attempt to improve the plight of humanity, even if just in a minor way. Which is why I'm so thankful for your intervention on its behalf. Now, I presume Nevin already got you up to speed. I need details before I talk to the heads of the Trackers Alliance. Make sure their members understand the retreat's off limits. So if you don't mind, I'd like to just jump right into it. Lily here will be taking notes as we go. Now, Nevin said all the various incidents afflicting the retreat, they all stemmed from this pair of rogue bounty hunters. Do I have that right? There were a streak of thefts and accidents leading up to Mr. Kilman's kidnapping. We'd presumed they were just bad luck or local fauna. Ixel's not exactly the most hospitable of worlds, but Nevin made it sound as if those bounty hunters might have been responsible for it all. And I was hoping you could confirm if that was the case or not. Good. Lily, make sure we get a copy of all that, will you?
Yes, Ms. Lance.
But Nevin did say you managed to get those two to leave the retreat alone. You mind my asking how you accomplished that? Two trackers and you just talked them down? That's quite the feat. I'm interested in the details, though. How exactly did it all play out? I'm sure it was. I've dealt with trackers. They tend to be a focused sort. So, only other thing I wanted to ask, and I'm just looking for an opinion here, is there anything in your eyes that could have been done to prevent this happening? After everything I've heard from you and Nevin, I'm inclined to agree. It'll take time to get the right people in place for this kind of work, but I'll make sure it's addressed. But that should give me enough to present to the Alliance. Thank you for making the time. Now, what you did, well, it deserves something more than just a couple of firm thank yous. Here, I want you to have these. They're a rare make. But I think you've earned it. Now, was there anything else you wanted to talk about before we went our separate ways? You make lots of friends in my position. Friends in the Freestar Collective. Friends in the UC. The sort of people with influence over things. Like, say, how much a locality is allowed to spend on Alliance contracts each quarter. When the Alliance heads grasped that it's better for us all to be friends, I expect they'll leave the retreat well enough alone. It's something that's been on my mind for a while now, how best to help the galaxy's incarcerated population. Humanity's tried plenty of bad ideas, throwing them in jail and forgetting about them. The UC gave that a go way back when. Took all their criminals to a penal colony on Suvorov and left them to their own devices. Well, those folks didn't appreciate that sort of treatment, took over the colony, and now we call them the Crimson Fleet. Next, we tried making them pay fines instead of going to jail. Except if you don't have the money, that's no sort of improvement at all, is it? Bad idea after bad idea. I thought it was time we tried something new. That's where the plans for the retreat came from. Our attempt at doing things different. That's kind of you, but without your help, it might have stayed just a goal. You have my sincere thanks. Now, if you'll excuse me, as you've seen, there's plenty to be done.
Hostility will not be tolerated.